morning, everyone. We're so glad that you are tuning in this morning. If this is your first time with us, please leave us a comment below. Also want to encourage you, if you have a prayer request at any time during the video, please leave us a comment. We would love to pray with you and agree with you in prayer. We'll be going into a short time of worship. After that, I'll be back and giving you a short devotional and continuing with our series on the Sermon on the Mount. God bless you guys. Good morning, everyone. We're here to continue our series on the Sermon on the Mount. This is week 6. And if you have your Bibles this morning, let's turn to Matthew chapter 7. We're going to read verses 24 through 27. And Jesus says, "Anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise, like a person who builds a house on solid rock. Though the rain comes and torrents and the floodwaters rise and the winds beat against that house, it won't collapse because it is built on bedrock. But anyone who hears my teaching and doesn't obey it is foolish, like a person who builds a house on sand. When the rain and the floods come and the winds beat against that house, it will collapse with a mighty crash." Here Jesus is tying this whole sermon all together. And Jesus has been teaching in this great sermon, and he begins to summarize it with this illustration. Verse 24 says, "Therefore, anyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice." You know, in many ways, Jesus's audience was probably no different than any church, you know, here in America. You know, I think we hear sermon after sermon, and there's sometimes when we hear it, we leave, we catch lunch, and then we don't really remember what was said from the pulpit. But Jesus is telling them, hey, look, anyone who hears what I said today and puts that into practice, this is what this person is like. You know, James encourages us in James chapter 1, verse 22. It says, "Do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says." See, listening to God's word requires action. Otherwise, we are deceiving ourselves, thinking that we've changed things and acted upon when all we've done is think about Jesus's message and not really do anything with it. Jesus was bringing a revolutionized message to them, saying, "Hey, hear it, listen to it, and then do something with it. Put it into practice. What will you do?" Is basically what he's saying. What will you do with this message? And I ask you that today. What will you do with the message that Jesus is speaking to us this morning? You know, in his parable, where he's talking about the builders building their houses, they had a lot of things in common. Both of them built homes. Both of them had immediate success. They both had similar goals and desires. And then they both faced storms. The difference between the two, however, was their foundation. One was built on sand. The other one was built on the bedrock. The sand had no substance. It had no, it may have looked good, but the difference between both of them was the storm. The storm is what set both of them apart. It was a storm that showed that one house was not sufficiently built, was not built correctly. And, you know, we all experience storms in our lives, and the storms in our lives are kind of what define us, you know? And I think a lot of us here in the Gulf Coast region can identify with storms, with tropical storms, with hurricanes. We look back, we can identify with these storms. We remember what we were doing or if our house sustained damage or if we missed it. We all remember those things. And so this morning, I want to encourage you to examine your heart, examine your life, and look and see, where is my house? Where is my spiritual house built on? Is it built on the bedrock foundation of Christ? Or have I built my house on shifting sands that when a storm comes, it's not going to survive? There's one thing that we all have in common. We're all going to experience storms. We're all going to have tragedies. Jesus says those things, but he encourages us that those who are following him, those who are who have built their house on the foundation of Christ, we will withstand the storm. We will be sustained by his power, by his mercy, and by his grace. So as we wrap up, I just want to ask you this morning, what foundation have you built on? Is it built on that bedrock? Is it built on sand? This is your opportunity to start to rebuild. This is your opportunity to start putting your spiritual house in order. It's not too late. It's not too late to begin to do that. So I want to encourage you today to examine your heart, examine your life. Bring your family around you and begin to talk about those things. Begin to talk about ways to say, okay, we've heard these messages over the last 6 weeks. What do we need to do for our house to be built on the solid rock foundation of Jesus. Because when you do, you will make it through the toughest seasons, you will make it through the toughest storms, and you will be strong and sustained in the power of Jesus. God bless you guys. Let me bless you in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord show you his favor and give you his peace. God bless you guys. We'll see you next week.